some serious work. No, the peace process is not dead, but I think that we've had too much process and not enough peace, as His Majesty King Abdullah II says. I believe that there is a call to action by all at this General Assembly to try, on the one hand, as the Quartet statement said right after the announcement of President Abbas, that they took note of the Palestinian application for statehood, but at the same time they set a time frame for negotiations. And for the first time we see a clear-cut Quartet statement talking about a preparatory meeting between the parties within 30 days, immediate discussion on borders and security within 3 months, progress within 6 months, and an end to discussion by the end of 2012. So I think we have to work on multiple tracks, and at the end of the day, I think there's a world consensus out there that the Palestinians deserve their statehood and that the Middle East, Israel, and the Arabs deserve to live in peace and security.
But at least so far, the Palestinian Authority President Mahmoud Abbas says until Israel stops building settlements on the West Bank, they're not going to accept that recommendation from the so-called quartet, the U.S., Russia, the EU, and the UN. They're not going to go along with it.
Well, let me answer this question in a different way. If you go back to the quartet statement, you're talking about a beginning of discussion on borders and security within 3 months and clear progress within 6 months. When you talk about borders and security, Wolf, and you're an expert on the region, having lived this conflict with all of us over many decades, when you set the borders, when you agree on the borders, then the settlement issue is retroactively resolved. Settlements are illegal. They are illegitimate. That's a consensus. World position, but at the same time, I think we have all final status issues that are on the table. Refugees, Jerusalem, borders, security, water, everything. And I think settlement is part of that. Provocative action, unilateral provocative action, particularly by Israel and settling in Jerusalem, is of course something that's going to hamper negotiations. And I think if we're going to enter into this this process of negotiating in earnest, then we should avoid these provocative actions on the ground.
We recently, Foreign Minister, saw the Israeli embassy in Cairo looted and stormed. You're familiar with that. We also saw some massive demonstrations in Amman at the Israeli embassy there. Israeli diplomats weren't there at the time. Apparently, they were evacuated. What's your relationship with Israel like today?
It could be better, but we have diplomatic relations, and we, of course, abide by the Vienna Convention, just like we expect all the countries that we have diplomatic relations with to abide by that convention. But at the same time, the pressure is on in the entire Middle East, Wolf. I think if you look at Israel today, it is becoming more and more isolated. Look at the tensions, as you mentioned, with Egypt. Look at the tensions with Turkey. Look at the tensions with the Palestinians. And I think at the end of the day, you know, you can read between the lines. We are committed to our peace treaty with Israel, but at the same time, we need to see serious, tangible progress on giving the Palestinians their inalienable right to statehood. And I think as part of a comprehensive settlement to the Arab-Israeli conflict, so that Israel can be part of the region, not just in the region.
Let's talk about your neighbor.